guys, welcome back. My name is Emma. Welcome back to the craziness that is my life and everything in between. I have decided to give myself a very extreme challenge. I heard about Pamela Reif and her ab workout from hell, but I am going to do Pamela Reif's ab workout every day for 7 days on top of doing 12-3-30 by Lauren Giraldo, which I have done before. And if you're interested, I'll go ahead and link it above. You guys kind of go ahead and watch that one. So this is going to be a combo. And I'm nervous, I'm gonna be honest, because I've seen one review on this and the results were really good. And so I'm like, why not? Let me give it a try, because my abs are definitely one of those spaces where I am struggling. I went ahead and took some initial measurements. Here is actually a view of how my body looked before I am starting this challenge. My measurements are going to be right here for you guys to see. And then, all right, that's it. I'm trying not to do long intros, because I've noticed people keep clicking off videos and my intros are too long. So let us get into day one.
Damn it.
Just wanna know if you mean it. What you think about me? What you think about me? I just wanna know if you feel it. What I'm feeling about you. I will always focus on what's best for me. When I see your body, there's no in between. I can't get tired.
There were people in the gym today, so I didn't get to make any comments after my workout because it was incredibly awkward. But the Pamela Reif workout, I didn't even get through the whole thing. I honestly, like, my muscles are just not up to par. And then 12-3-30, I just sweat so bad. So I think today was probably a really good start. Hopefully the rest of the beach is good as well and I just continue to improve. There's so much sweat and salt in my eyes right now. It burns. And now I have to go get ready for work and then walk 30 minutes to work. So more exercise, yay. On to, I guess, the next one. So see you guys tomorrow.
Day two,
headed
to the gym. Hopefully no one's there today.
My abs still hurt from yesterday.
My new routine, I swear you're blowing my mind. I'll take you to Paris. Can you feel the love?
Like 75% of the way through the ab workout, but I didn't make it all the way through again, and my 12-3-30 went great, so I'm proud of myself. So today I'm just gonna do a 12-3-30 and I'm gonna skip the ab workout because my abs actually hurt a lot and I don't want to damage the muscles because I need to do some repair work, so I'm just gonna give them a day off. Let's get going on this cardio.
Everybody's got their own demons. Wanna face mine with you, wanna face mine with you. Fall and spring gave me a new reason. Oh, gotta fall and grow like leaves. I will always focus on what's.
I feel like the stretching really helps wake me up in the morning so that I actually have more motivation to do this. I've just noticed that if I just start right away, I'm like bleh. But if I do a little bit of stretching, it actually does help wake me up. And I can do my exercise and that just makes me feel better, so. Hot tip, stretch before if you feel too tired. It helps wake you up, at least it does for me.
I just started and I feel like I already need water. Maybe because it's 6:56 a.m. See you guys on the other side.
It
should just start coming to the gym at like 5:30 because I'm really sick and tired of people coming in and then I can't say anything afterwards. But I think it went really well today. I got through most of my episode, well, most of the second half of my episode. Yeah, I think it was great. Another like 230 calories. Tomorrow I should be back to the ab workouts. I just really, really needed to give it a day to rest. I would call today still a success.
Take care of Paris. Nothing's the same now. I'll take you anywhere you want. My energy decreases. I need someone, need to pick me up. There's nothing left, but I can't stop. Every night I'm in bed all alone. It's hard to fall asleep cause I can't come back home.
This is just a side comment. I'm watching this K-drama and I'm dying physically and emotionally, but this is getting me through this workout right now. Oh my God.
Every day with 12:30 is always harder and harder, and seriously, bring something to watch, or it's so tough. Music's not enough. So I've been bingeing this K-drama, and it's literally what gets me through the morning because your mind is somewhere else. But I'm drenched again today, and my legs were burning a lot in the beginning, so I think that's pretty good. So I would call today a success as well. So that was day four.
Today's day six. Yesterday was day five. And honestly, like, I've been working out every single day for 3 weeks without really taking a break. So I really needed a break yesterday. So I'm not sure if I want to add one day to this yet or be very honest about the fact that doing these two workouts back to back is very tiring and doing it for 7 days is tough. Yeah, I mean, this morning's a little rough. I had some spicy kimchi, like pork stew last night, also known as kimchi jjigae, and I had some makgeolli, which is Korean rice wine, which probably wasn't the smartest idea. And so I woke up with my stomach not being in the best mood. So I'm hoping that that isn't gonna hinder me too much this morning. I've really been trying to be careful about alcohol and sweets. Unfortunately, I have a boyfriend who likes to have a drink on weekends and eats a lot of sweets. And so it's very difficult to avoid those, but I'm doing the best that I can. You know, he might eat 2 cupcakes and I might have like a nibble of one of them. Probably still not gonna get through today's workout. This thing absolutely kicks my ass.
No matter what you say, I just got to be strong. I need to move on. Oh, I'm trying to start over.
Okay, so today
burned. I do think that today was like my best day of doing the ab workout. I got through more of it, but it's still something that I think by the end of these 7 days, I'm not gonna be able to do in whole. And then I also think that, I don't know, the 12:30 half was just like my legs burned, which is good because it means that my muscles are being worked, but whoo, damn. All right, well, taken by all of this beautiful sweat, it was a good day. Day 7, let's go.
I've been waiting for somebody. I need someone who can clear my mind. And still I miss your company, but it's just the way you made me hate me. Every night I'm in bed all alone. It's hard to fall asleep cause I can't come back home. No matter what you say, I just got to be strong. I need to move on. I'm trying to start over.
This the honest workout, it's tough, and I think my thighs are just so heavy and my core is so weak that I could sometimes barely get through like the whole thing. I think today was maybe the best, maybe it was yesterday, but thank God that half is done. Now we're gonna do the 12:30 and to wrap up the last day of this challenge. Yay. Okay, I'll see you guys at the end. I'm done! Yay! Actually, that 12:30 wasn't bad. It burned my legs a lot, but I got through the 30 minutes so easily. And so, we're gonna take measurements and photos in the morning, and I am so excited to see what happened. Yeah, I'm done. This was challenging, but another one in the books.
All right, and another one in the bag. So, I don't know. I felt like doing just an ab workout every single day just wasn't going to be enough of a challenge for my body. So I thought, let's combine it with something a little bit more strenuous and see if it could potentially maximize the results. And now I'm just kind of like, let's see how everything went. I did have to take one rest day. So this was really more like 6 days instead of 7, but it was just because the ab workout was just, I have to admit to myself that I have almost no core strength whatsoever, just for full transparency. Okay, so here's a side-by-side of the final results. I wore almost the same thing, so I feel like this is a pretty accurate comparison. I look miserable, so that's fun, but I think it's kind of hard to tell. I think you can kind of see there was like maybe a little slimming. I would just say in general, I don't really think there was much of a difference, but if we go ahead and look at the measurements themselves, I did lose a little bit of muscle in my arms, which is not ideal, but not unexpected considering none of this was really any upper body. My thighs did lose a little bit, which is always beautiful. My waist, according to my tape measure, didn't change, which it's fine because the waist, your stomach, always the last thing to budge. It's just a little depressing. From a weight standpoint, almost 2 pounds. So for a week, that's pretty standard. And then body fat, which is always the biggest key metric, 0.5%. So that's not too bad. So would I recommend this? If you want to challenge yourself, I would say yes. I do think that as the days went on, the ab exercises did become a little bit easier. But in general, I think this really taught me that like my core strength is just very sad and that I need to work on it dramatically. That is something that we are going to probably add to the list, is a lot more core training. This was not fun. I didn't enjoy this. And I think that's probably one of the big things, is when I'm trying to do these, I'm trying to find things that are challenging that I'm going to enjoy. And I just don't think this was one of them. Like, I don't think there was anything wrong with Pamela's ab workout. It was just that she didn't talk at all. And she was very like stone face, and she just looked super perfect throughout the entire video. I'm just laying there dying, and like, when did she sweat? But for me, they just seemed a little distant, which I guess I didn't care for that. I prefer fitness YouTubers that are a little bit more interactive and with like the audience, but I think it was a good workout. I just don't think I liked her presentation. If you've ever done one of Pamela's workouts or if you want to give this challenge a try, let me know what you think in the comments. But that is it for today. Thank you so much. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye. See you.